Hi, in this review, we will be looking closely at the Roborock S6 Pure. This model is one of the newer Roborock options that also includes the S5 Max and the S6 MaxV. The Pure variant is the cheapest in the S6 product line, but based on my tests, which I'll share with you in a bit, it has more airflow than the S6 MaxV and scores high marks in the surface cleaning tests. If you don't mind not having the obstacle avoidance system found in the S6 MaxV, the Pure might be a great alternative that costs less. Roborock says that the S6 Pure only has 4 clip sensors, while the S6 has an extra 2. The wall sensors were also downgraded from a LiDAR system to an infrared system. Still, the navigation tests show that these downgrades don't have a significant impact on how it traverses around the edges and cliff points. It has the same smart navigating capabilities of the S6 MaxV minus the obstacle avoidance system. Hi, I'm Garrick and welcome to the Cordless Vacuum Guide. If it's your first time in this channel, consider subscribing and tap on the bell icon to get notified when I publish new reviews. For more information about the Roborock S6 Pure, please check the links in the video description below. Now, let's get started. Currently, there are 3 S6 variants available: the S6, the S6 Pure, and the S6 MaxV. Like what I've said earlier, the S6 Pure is a slight downgrade from the S6, while the S6 MaxV is the most premium option with the reactive AI software and front-mounted camera that aids it in avoiding obstacles. Don't misinterpret the downgrades to subpar performance, as the S6 Pure is one of the best so far that I've tested when it comes to surface cleaning and airflow. One of the biggest surprises for me is the airflow test results. The S6 Pure outperforms the S6 MaxV in all the power settings and has more airflow in the highest setting compared to the S5 Max. The uptick in airflow is most evident in the sand on hard floor test, where the S6 Pure picked up an average of 100% on 2 tests where I set it at the max power setting. It also did well in silent mode as it picked up 99.2%. If you live near the beach, the S6 Pure is something to consider as it does very well at cleaning sand on hard surfaces. For the deep cleaning test, I rubbed 100 grams of sand on mid-pile carpet to see how much it picks up. It didn't do as well as the S5 Max or the S6 MaxV in the deep cleaning test, only picking up an average of 72% on 2 tests. Where this robot shines is surface cleaning. Regardless of the debris size scattered on the surface, it was able to pick up almost everything in its path. The S6 Pure can clean large debris like Cheerios, Fruit Loops, and smaller particles like dust, pet litter, and coffee grounds. There were no issues of Fruit Loops clogging in the suction chamber. The only limiting factor would be the dustbin capacity, which is only 0.5 liters, so you'll have to empty it quite often. In 6 of the surface debris tests, it was able to pick up 100%. You can check the link to the review on my blog below to see the complete results. One potential issue is the placement of the exhaust, which is at the back, as it can scatter lighter debris like dust and quinoa that gets in the way. I also did a hair wrap test with 1 gram of human hair between 5 to 7 inches long on hard floors and low pile carpet. And this was how much hair it picked up on hard floors. And this was how much it wrapped around the brush roll. It did slightly better on carpet as it picked up more with slightly less hair wrapping around the brush. One reason why is that I used the balance setting while testing it on hard floors and used the max setting on carpet. Regardless of the surface, you'll have to regularly check the brush roll for any hair that may wrap around the bristles and axles if you live with someone who has long hair. Edge cleaning is decent but not exceptional because of the round shape and narrow brush roll. The side brush that spins rapidly at the edges will also scatter debris further. In the test, it was able to pick up most of the coffee grounds I scattered, but it did not pick up the debris that went in the quarter-inch crevice. For a mess this big, you'll probably have to run the robot 2 or 3 times to pick up everything. Aside from vacuuming floors, the S6 Pure can also mop floors. It has a slightly larger water tank than the S6, but I don't think the difference matters much when it comes to coverage. I tested it on dried red wine and grape juice stains, and it did a very decent job at removing nearly all of the stains, though it left some residue on the surface, maybe because the microfiber pad wasn't damp enough. Another possible reason would be the lack of a spring-loaded system that keeps down mud pressure on the pad. Please take note that the S6 Pure only has the gravity tank and not the electronic water tank found in the S5 Max and S6 MaxV, so it doesn't have the capability of adjusting the flow of water to the pad. The S6 Pure retains most of the navigational features of the S6 MaxV, but minus the obstacle avoidance system because it does not have the front-facing camera. It is compatible with the Roborock app, and users will have access to features like no-go zones and invisible wall, which I really like. However, it does not have access to the no-mop zones, which I think is irrelevant because the no-go zones has the same functionality. It also has the multi-level map feature, so users have the option to turn this feature on and save up to 4 map levels. The beauty of this feature is that the robot will automatically detect the correct map level based on the initial scan before the run, so it's somewhat idiot-proof in that aspect. Another strong point of the S6 Pure is the noise level, or the lack thereof. Using a sound meter from a few feet away, the highest level I recorded was 63.7 decibels at the max setting, which is lower than S6 MaxV's 65 decibels. To give you an idea of the noise levels, here's a demo of the loudness at each of the power settings. Overall, the S6 Pure is an excellent robot with advanced navigational features that allow it to clean multi-room and multi-level homes with precision and efficiency. If you don't mind not having the obstacle avoidance system of the S6 MaxV or the advanced electronic water tank found in the S5 Max, this is a good and less expensive alternative that will clean almost as well as the other two more expensive options. If you have any questions about this product, please leave those in the comment section below and I'll answer them as soon as possible. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you find a lot of value from it, subscribe and tap on the bell icon to get notified when I'm publishing reviews. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.